Hi guys, welcome back to Nurse Minder. This is Tammy, your host, and today we're talking about the respiratory rate, especially the tricky part of counting it in your patients, because once they become aware, that can be a little bit harder to get a true respiratory rate. So we're going to talk about that right after this. Welcome back. My name is Tammy and this is Nurse Minder, and on this channel we do everything nursing. So if you're new here, consider subscribing below so that you get the next video when it's released. Welcome back. Today we're talking about the respiratory rate and how to gather that information from your patient without them really knowing that you're watching for it. Now let me know in the comments below if this sounds like something you've done before. You maybe have noticed a family member sleeping on the couch or your spouse, and you're like, oh my God, are they even breathing? And you stare at them and you try to see the rise and the fall of their chest or to hear the inhalation, exhalation, and it's a real panicked moment. Well, we do that with our patients too, but we don't want to stare at them. In fact, we want to make sure they are breathing. And so we might come in and do an assessment on them, which would include their vital signs. And part of that vital signs is doing a respiratory rate. Now, a normal respiratory rate is 10 to 20 breaths per minute or 12 to 20 breaths per minute, depending on the textbook that you are using and the resource that you are using. And those numbers include a complete rise and fall of the chest. Now, in some patients, this is super easy to identify. They have a visible rise and a visible fall of the chest, or you can hear that sound. In other patients, this can be quite tricky and it may require a few different tricks. So I'm going to show you some strategies later in the video. Now, the respiratory rate is one part of your respiratory system assessment. And when we're looking at the rate, we're also looking to see if it is a regular rhythm in that it's a predictable pattern, or an irregular rhythm in that maybe we've got some fast, 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 slow, absent, periods of apnea maybe where there is no breathing. You want to count those seconds if there is. And then all of a sudden there's a big gasp and then fast, fast, slow. So that would be like an irregular rhythm. We want to identify the difference between regular and irregular. And the second piece of that is we want to know how much effort are they having to utilize in order to get that breath in. So a labored breathing would look something like this. What you're noticing there is hiking of the shoulders, mouth breathing, really heavy rise of the chest, and a fast pattern. So there might be some labored work to it. Other pieces you would be looking for would in the trachea. You'd want to notice if there's any indrawing, so like that. They're trying to work so hard that you see these indrawing. Nasal flaring. You'll see some shoulder hiking potentially, and maybe some indrawing of the muscles in the neck by the trachea, in the rib intercostal spaces, or under the diaphragm, under here. Now, counting the respiratory rate does become tricky when the patient is aware, because once somebody knows that they're being watched, they tend to focus on their breathing and it becomes not a regular rate for them. And so the tricky part is, as a healthcare provider, is to get it when they don't know you're watching. Now, when it comes to the female patient, there tends to be a little bit of awkwardness around that because you feel like you're staring at the chest. But you don't have to stare at the chest, right? Now, if your patient's in bed, one of the things you can do is take their pulse, and you can either hold their hand across their belly so that you can palpate the pulse for 30 seconds and then feel the respirations for the next 30. Or you can keep their hand up in the air, and as you're doing that, you're visualizing past. So you would be holding my pulse at this point, and after 30 seconds, you just shift your gaze from the pulse just past the hand, and then you would watch the rise and the fall of the chest. And your patient will think that your vision is still on the pulse because you only have to look
ever so slightly beyond it. Now, if you counted 6 breaths in 30 seconds, you would be correct. Multiply that by 2 and you can have 12 breaths per minute as your rate because this was a regular unlabored rhythm.
Now, tip number 2 is you may actually physically have to put your hand on their chest to feel. Some of our patients that are sedated, maybe they've got too much medication, they're sleeping really heavily, they've got a disease process where they're not as alert, and so maybe they're just breathing shallow normally. Put your hand on their chest to see if you can feel the slight rise and fall and then count those. Now, if the chest is too obvious for your patient, you can then maybe put your hand on their shoulder or the back and just feel. And tip number 3, if neither of those work, is to do it while you're auscultating the heart. So you just tell the patient you're going to listen to their heart for a while, breathe normal, relax, and then while you're there, you can hear the inhalation and exhalation and count those cycles as well. Now, the respiratory rate is an important element of the respiratory system assessment. It tells us whether or not the patient is breathing in the normal parameter, which is between 12 and 20, and that would be an expected rate, and with a normal volume in order to meet the needs of the body. Now, I have talked about lung volumes before in a previous video, so I'll pop up a little link here for you there so you can understand the importance of that volume. And then we've also talked about measuring oxygen in a oxygen sat probe video, so I'll pop that card up here as well for you so that you can identify if the saturation is matching what you're seeing clinically. Now, we always treat the patient, not the number. Now, sometimes those machines on the wall, there will be some vibrations and it might be giving you an irregular number on the machine. So you always want to check your patient first and assess them manually. So there you have it. The respiratory rate can be very tricky, but with these tips, I think you're going to find greater success.